Hi, this is Joe Hartley, and welcome to my presentation of Hex Signs of the Pennsylvania Dutch. This is a look into the rich history and some of the art of the immigrants to the New World known as the Pennsylvania Dutch. This will examine folklore, fakelore, and some of the traditions carried on, and in some cases started by, the folk that call themselves the Pennsylvania Dutch, and in the use of the folk art that has become known as hex signs. The term Pennsylvania Dutch, or Pennsylvania German, refers to a cultural group formed by early German-speaking immigrants to Pennsylvania and their descendants. They are not only originally from Germany and Switzerland, but also include German-speaking immigrants from northeast France near Belgium, Luxembourg, Switzerland, and Germany. They came to this part of the United States because of the promise of religious freedom and economic opportunity offered by Williams Penn's colony, founded in 1681. While it's often thought that the term Dutch is due to the misinterpretation of the word Duits or German, back in the 18th and 19th century, the word Dutch referred to anyone from a wide range of Germanic regions such as the Netherlands, Belgium, Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. The Amish make up only a small portion of the Pennsylvania Dutch. Other groups include German Lutheran, German Reformed, Mennonites, and the Swiss Brethren. They're referred to as Dutch because of their German ancestry. Hex signs have been the name bestowed upon the folk art inspired by barn stars, typically found adorning the sides of barns in rural Pennsylvania, and are especially prominent in the Berks County area. The symbols quite effectively break the monotony of what would otherwise be a huge area of wooden planks. Unlike barn stars, which are painted directly on the sides of structures, the wooden hex signs painted on discs are now popular throughout Pennsylvania, are quite portable, and can be hung anywhere. Hex signs can be found at numerous local shops in the area, catering to a demand of souvenirs for tourists traveling through the area. Old Route 22 has been nicknamed the Hex Highway because of all the souvenir shops in the area and the folk art which is visible on the buildings along this 87-mile stretch of road. The hex signs of the Pennsylvania Dutch have a very interesting and somewhat controversial history. The simplest version is that they are simply there to decorate an otherwise unattractive structure and have no hidden deeper significance. Pennsylvania Dutch use these same designs on their furniture, bed quilts, birth and wedding certificates, and just about every other aspect of their daily lives. Prior to the Industrial Revolution, only the very wealthy could afford to paint buildings. The earliest barn star found about dates back to 1819 and was the only painted surface of the barn building. Early barn stars consisted of geometric patterns with animals added in the early 1900s. The barn stars became known as hex signs in 1952 thanks to Milton Hill, a painter who demonstrated his art at the Kutztown Folk Festival by demonstrating painting barn stars on large wooden panels. Because of the numerous requests from people who wished to buy them, Milton began painting his art on plywood circles and selling them. In the late 1950s, local artist Johnny Ott found these sold much better if he made them with superstitious meaning added to them, and the hex sign was created. In the 1960s, I teamed up with another local artist, Jacob Zook, and started mass-producing these signs. It also helped that there was already a common misconception of barn stars associated with witchcraft due to two articles from 1924. In the October 1924 Journal of the American Institute of Architects, the article stated of the barn stars, some said to be symbolic and also said not to be. Also in 1924, Wallace Nutting wrote an article in Pennsylvania Beautiful which stated, "The ornaments on barns found in Pennsylvania and to some extent west in West Jersey go by the local name of hexafoos or witchfoot. They are supposed to be a continuance of a very ancient tradition according to which these decorative marks were potent to protect the barn, or more particularly the cattle, from the influence of witches. The hexafoos was added to its decoration as a spiritual or demonic lightning rod." The problem was, Wallace got this astounding fact from a single informant whom he most likely misunderstood due to the Pennsylvania Dutch dialect. Regardless of how folklore may have turned into fakelore and now into folk art, the hex signs meet the definition of material culture and things we make as defined in our textbook folklore rules. While the symbolism, if any, in the original Barnstar folk art may be questionable, the symbolism associated with the hex signs was done with purpose. Black signifies protection, blends and binds elements together. Blue, protection, peace, spirituality, and calm. Brown, earth, friendship, and strength. Green, growth, fertility, success, and ideas. Orange, abundance. Red, emotions, passion, charisma, lust. Purple, royalty, all things sacred, and religion. White, purity, moon power, free-flowing energy, and yellow, health, love, sun, and connection to God. Cows, horses, or livestock represent keeping farm animals and pets healthy. Lambs represent children, innocence, and wonder. Snakes represent temptation. Unicorns symbolize piety and virtue. Bird of paradise symbolizes beauty, wonder, and mystery of life. The distelfink, or goldfinch, symbolizes good luck and happiness. Doves represent friendship and peace in marriage. Eagles symbolize strength, courage, and protection. Roosters also symbolize strength, courage, and protection. Leaves represent long life, strength, and nature. Pineapple represents warmth and hospitality for all. Pomegranate symbolizes abundance and fertility. Shamrock represents luck and the luck of the Irish. Tulips represent faith, hope, and charity. Wheat represents abundance. The common shapes and designs found in hex signs are said to have the following meanings. Barn wheel, wheel of fortune. Crescent moons, shown in a swirl pattern to represent the four seasons. Daddy hex, used to bring good luck all year. Haussegen, home blessing in German. Hearts, hearts represent love. Raindrops represents water and crop abundance. Rosettes, the oldest symbol, good luck. Scallops represent ocean waves and smooth sailing through life. Stars generally represent luck and protection. Swastika symbolizes good fortune and well-being. Sun, rain, and fertility motif, abundance in field, barn, and home. Wickham or Wickham, two different ways to say welcome in Dutch. It turns out Johnny Ott, who helped hex signs gain popularity by attributing special meanings to them, may have actually put good luck hexes on them as a practitioner of powwowing, a Pennsylvania Dutch set of folk beliefs. Powwowing is very much still currently practiced by modern Pennsylvania Dutch today. There are many disagreements regarding the true purpose of hex signs. Dr. August C. Marr, professor at Ohio State University, wrote several articles convinced that the signs not only had meaning, but they were indeed hex signs, looked upon by their painters and possessors as having magical protective powers. Dr. Elbert L. Shoemaker was certain the signs were not used for any type of magical purposes. From his wide research in both Europe and America, Shoemaker came to the conclusion that the hex signs were pure and simple decorative motifs. Barn stars were used as a decorative way to adorn an otherwise plain barn. The adaptation to hex signs was an opportunity to share this folk art with those that appreciated it. Giving special and perhaps even magical properties to the hex signs was both a good sales tool and a way to carry out a belief, powwowing, that had been around for hundreds of years and put to a new use. It's easy to understand why barn stars and hex signs have been assumed to always represent more than decorative folk art. Some of the symbols contained in hex signs, such as pentagrams, hexagrams, and octagrams, are often associated with the Stoic symbols found in the occult and Teutonic mythology. They are also very similar to other images involving spiritual awareness, such as the wheels of energy depicted by the chakras shown here on the right. How does this compare to what we discussed in class? Well, in class we learned how stories change as they're handed down from generation to generation. In hex sign folk art, we have seen how an art form changes from barn stars painted on sides of buildings and grows into a new form. Hex signs, portable barn stars given a new meaning in order to enhance sales, and gives way to a new tradition. Displaying hex signs for good luck and prosperity. What can be learned about the society? Hex signs are certainly symbolic of the skill and craftsmanship handed down over the generations and found in the folk art to the Pennsylvania Dutch. The fine quality handmade furniture and crafts from this area are still highly sought after today. And thank you for watching.